Hey guys, today we're going to be installing the 75mm throttle body. So we got this from Z1 Motorsports. I'll explain why we got it from them specifically, but it's still the Hitachi 75mm. And at first glance, you can see like it actually is a good amount of difference. The opening for factory is 70mm. Also on the intake manifold, it's 70mm. And then you step down or you step up from 75 back down with their adapter. So hopefully it's just gonna let in more air and create more velocity because it's probably gonna act a little bit like a velocity stack. We can also argue by upping the diameter of the throttle body from the original 7mm will help displace what the butterfly valve occupies. So even though we're bigger in diameter on the throttle body, yes, the mass airflow in the airbox, our factory 2006 airbox, is still small. And also the inlet into the intake manifold is still 70mm. That's why for the longest time I didn't want to put on the bigger throttle body. But then when I looked at it, it's like, well, you're helping displace this. So the theory, you're much closer to having the same diameter all the way through because that valve does take up some space. The kit comes with all the necessary hardware and two gaskets to adapt on your throttle body and also a wire harness adapter. I am going to run a third gasket and you'll see why with our little coolant bypass. Before starting the job, make sure to disconnect the negative terminal of the battery. Also hit the horn and the brakes to discharge any energy in the capacitors. So you can see why I'm using the third gasket. So staying true to our touring build, the theory is we would use this car any time of the year. So we have our coolant bypass here. So it should in theory still give enough heat to prevent the throttle body from freezing. We don't technically need it for how we're using the vehicle. So if you're going for all-out performance, don't do this one. Get the actual bypass that has the valve on it, especially if you're driving during summer months. But we're just trying to keep the build as realistic as we can. So what's interesting here is because I already beveled the intake, if you look at our intake video. So here, it actually lines up, and over here, it's a bit reduced in diameter, which I'm fine with because the air is gonna hit that back wall more than anything. So looking at it, this is what it's gonna look like if you have the same setup. Also recommend a little bit of threadlock blue on the fasteners that attach the throttle body adapter to the intake manifold. Now, when you're torquing it down with these gaskets, I would go in increments. So set your torque wrench in increments. Don't go for it right away. That gives it a chance for everything to seal and compress and actually get to its actual torque setting. Remember, these don't need much. This is just aluminum. It's very soft. So you don't want to wreck anything. Okay, with everything all tightened down on the adapter, we can go ahead and put our throttle body on. So again, tighten stages. Now when you're handling the throttle body, don't touch the butterfly and don't push on the butterfly because you can throw it out of calibration. So you can see that it's clocked because that way this end goes down and then we don't have hood clearance issues and this part that protrudes is going to end up in this area where it's raised a little bit. Here is our harness adapter. Put a little bit, just a little bit of dielectric grease in. Okay, so before we put on the intake tube, we're going to go ahead and check the operation of the throttle body. All we're going to do is turn on the ignition and now we're going to turn off. Okay, so it does a self-check, so we know it has power. Okay, so we're just testing operation of the throttle body, so we're going to give it some throttle. So wide open. Okay, halfway. All the way, all the pedal to the ground. There we go. Okay, now shut off the ignition. So we know we have operation. When putting these tubes on, having these hose pick sets definitely makes the job a lot easier to get around the bottom area. Another challenge with a larger throttle body is figuring out how you're going to adapt it onto the intake tube. So I have a Mishimoto version on here. And what we did was the night prior, we actually had it on the throttle body just to help stretch it out to make installation on the car a little bit easier. If you're running an aftermarket tube or even the factory plastic tube, you're going to have to look into Z1's coupler to make this all work. Well, there you guys have it. That's how to install the bigger throttle body and some considerations that you need to make.